1-0. Hi, everybody. It's time for another day on the farm. Hope everybody's having a good Thursday. We're here to farm. And we're going to find out what we're going to be doing here in just a minute. We're loading up a new map. Elm Creek. No, sorry. North Dakota. It's available online from a, it's this map here. So, we're going to jump into it. We got some other mods here we're going to check out as we go through this as well. But above all, we're just here to farm on a Thursday night. Have some fun. Chill out. All that kind of good stuff. So let's load in. If you're hanging out, whether it's snowing or it's raining, or if the sun is shining, hope that you're having a good day. We're going to find out. Have it not freeze. It's going to think. It's going to think hard. And we got to 100. No issues on load. 100%. Let's jump in. We're starting on farm manager mode. Well, we would be normally starting on farm manager mode. There we go. Took a second. It's a big map. It's going to take a minute to load in a whole bunch of shaders. Just give it a second for it to settle itself out. It's a big map. I haven't looked at it besides the screenshots. But we'll check it out here as soon as it decides it wants to go. Boy howdy though, it is thinking. Thinking real hard. Thinking really hard. Give it another minute. Let's see if it wants to go. (Clears throat) I had it on the pause screen for a second. Yeah, we're gonna try relaunch here real quick. See if we can get it to go again. It thought real hard. Once more with feeling. All right. There we go. Let's get rid of that. All right. We've got Farmer Dwitters here. Looking hot as ever. Hello, Russian friend. Go ahead and let auto drive do its thing. And then let's go ahead and look at the map. Where in even are we? We are by okay, I got a garage. I'm assuming that we're ah, there we go. Okay, we're down here at 144 and 145. It's interesting how they've... ah, there we go. It just took the map a while for it to decide it wanted to load. Now we can see the farmland delineations. Okay, just everything takes a second. All right, so we're here in 144, 145. Let's find out what is in... we got oats in 145. Potatoes in 144. Whole bunch of canola in 126. Bunch of soybeans in 147. Wheat up in 143. Green grass. First of all, I suppose I should do this. We got a little bit of grass, like up here. In 180. So this looks like a spot that could be a farm. Bunch of bins up there. Can I transport there? I cannot. What else we got up here in 180? Should be. One seventy-five, a ton of corn. 178 has oats. 179 is gonna have potatoes. Nope. Sorghum. Okay. What else we got on the map here? Whole bunch of nothing over there. What's going on up here? Okay, we got a couple of that's a nice cotton field up in 39. Expensive cotton field, but I'll be ready to go here in 2 months. I'm curious as to how, I guess it's this dirt road to get back up there. Yeah, let's look at what else we got here. So it's got sunflowers, it's got cotton, some soybeans, and some canola. Soybeans, cotton, sunflowers, canola. Canola should be harvestable, right? Yeah. What other spots do we have on the map here? Yeah, see, they didn't draw it perfectly, so it's hard to get farms carved out of there. Like, that's a farm. That might be an interesting place to start. What we got here? Got oats, barley. Nope. It could be an interesting spot. That would be wheat ready to harvest, followed by corn. Sunflowers, if you really felt like doing that. I think that might be a good start. Okay, so we're gonna buy that piece, that piece. And that piece. Slow the game speed way down. We are starting with no buildings or no vehicles. So, let's start with one of these boys for multi-use. We definitely want the beefier engine. Actually, okay, so let's think about this. The first thing that we have is we're going to have to harvest a field. It is a wheat field. So we're going to want a harvester. Oh, we don't want to go the whole way out in the woods right now. Let's start small. 387. Yeah, let's get the deer. Okay. Okay, get that guy, and then we need a header for it. Go with that one. We're gonna want a header trailer. So we can cart this thing around. All right, so trailer. Come on. That's under the header. Header trailers, there we go. One of those. And then teleport to our vehicle. We need to do something with that. Okay, first thing we first, we need to look and see, are there contracts on this map? There are contracts. Okay, so we can do things. So we're gonna go make this autosave, normal difficulty, traffic, seasons, 4-day seasons, snow, all of this stuff, dirt normal, turn off automatic engine start, turn on the fill limit to max weight. Normal fuel usage, workers can't buy reef, automatically buy, and manual attachment for now. We're gonna maybe come back to that one. Okay, we're in halftime right now, which is fine. Come on. Should be here. Yeah, I thought manual attachment was on. Okay. So then, put that onto there. Alright, this should be connected up now. Such to the point where it shouldn't, like, eat itself into next century. Oh, is this gonna be manually attached? Does this have an attachment point? Yes, it does. Okay. Good. Now, let's check out auto drive. Are there any points? No. Are there any routes? A couple. Alright, so... there we go. Make this a two-way street. And start working our way out. Stop the recording. Back up a little bit. So, right. No. We go from here to that's right, I can only do that from inside of here. So we go from there. To there. Alright, so now I just need to figure out how to get to my farm. So if I am over here, and I am here, I need to come left, and then left. I'm not going to win this guy. Put on some tunes. Maybe. I suppose I should probably put on some stream appropriate music. And then we go like that? Sure, why not? Put on some chill beats. Chill beats, just taking a drive. Okay, so this is our left. So we should... Car passes. Start recording. Going down this way, staying to the right. But the wheat fields. Oh, we've got a while to go. we're just going to keep driving out past. See, enjoy the countryside. Hello, Aegis. Thanks for joining. We're in the middle of trying out this new map, and I haven't decided if I like it yet or not. It was a very long map. It's a very large map. We're not even halfway to our farm yet. I might switch back over to the other map I was working on. It's cute. They made a nice map here. Our harvester is just slow though too, I guess. Just the sweet, sweet sounds of chill corn. Just passing halfway down the stretch. Good news, once we get this done the first time, we can set auto drive to take care of it from here on out. So just the first time, just relaxing, checking out the view. Got a big old, what we got there? Ooh, sugar beets. Oh my god, that is a giant field of sugar beets. Wow, that is a giant field of sugar beets. And there's sunflowers just south of us. That is a lot of sugar beets. But we got ourselves a nice little, we got ourselves some corn, and we got ourselves some wheat. Probably going to replant grass on this field. And then I'm sure we're going to replant on 32 once we harvest it. Wait, do barley. Barley over there next. Because I think I want to go into cows this time around. And push the milk chains. And eventually do cows, sugar, eggs, strawberries. I think that's cakes. Yeah, I think that is cakes. We're gonna need to figure out what all we have over here, but first we're coming back to our farm. And here we are. Now, question number one, did he make the farmhouses interactable? Okay, so let's stop recording. We're gonna call, F is the train. That. I would like to show above put those. They're supposed to be up above the air. Ow. Above tractor, show tooltip, show next path. So let's go ahead, jump out. Well, first of all, let's build this over here. jump out. Detach the trailer. Right, there we go. Come on, buddy. I know you love the barn just as much as I do. I realize now this is probably not the best place. Let's do... Am I stuck? Nope, see, you saw nothing. There we go. That's better. Okay, so now I can grab that. Well, that should have just grabbed. Boy, you want to be persnickety today, huh? Okay, get him started there. Deer harvester. Turn on. All right, harvester, why are you not turning on? Is there some sort of connection I have to make here? Aha! That might help. I forgot about that part of... All right. Goodbye, friend. Now. We need to purchase a work. No. Alright. We need to purchase a let's see where this stuff can be sold. That's actually a good price on that mower, but I kind of wanted to get a big mower. At least one that Winrez. Come back to that. Hmm. Certainly 354 says to run that. And we definitely, now here's the thing. So we're gonna need a big hole. The silo for now. So this guy needs 350 horses. I'm pretty sure that means that we're looking at one of these guys. Okay, so we've got a tractor now. That's right. Nope. That'll do. And should be able to go drive to... God, son of a gun. You're missing some spots here, Jens. If I had to drive this back myself, it's gonna be a long trip. Alright, this is all okay. Nope, still can't. Let's figure out why not. But no. And here we go again. Cause I messed up the auto drive somewhere. But that's okay. because it's Thursday night, my friends. And we're just hanging out. Do 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 do. So, like I was talking about, we're going to get this corn wheat harvested. We are going to bale the straw. Probably going to loft it. Maybe. Turn it into hay. Eh. Anyway, we're going to bale it. We are going to get some chickens and some cows to get us started. And while we're driving here, let's go look at prices. Alright, so we can sell... milk. Okay. Eggs. There is a bakery on the map, but we might build our own. Also got corn. Whoa. CW McCall will be proud. Should I let them pass? I guess I'll be a good farmer. I enjoyed that. Is there a bioplant? Right, we're gonna get some greenhouses going too. We need to find water. Is there a bioplant that we'll buy? There's not. Okay. So we might build our own bioplant then. Yeah, and here's why this didn't work. Lie. They're just fine. Ta-da! Now he'll drive his way home. You... Okay, so we're gonna need... a baler. Do we want to bail this? That's a good question. That is a very good question if we want to bail this. I think the answer is yes. Hello, friendly Russian. I think the answer is yes, we do want to bail this. So we're going to need a bailer. That's easy enough to do. So we want a okay. We need a bailer. Do square bales. I like the idea of square bailing it. And then we need to load the bales. Definitely get, oops. I get one of those. And then you're still not there yet. We're gonna need a cedar to replant that field. Is it planting time yet though? Oh yeah, we're gonna grass it so we can start doing silage. So we want that guy. borrow some cash in the most joyous way possible by pressing the space bar. Capped out now. So let's think about this. We got the baler, we got the bail loader. We need to purchase facilities next to get the chickens and the So basically we need to, but we do need a cedar. In the wrong menu, that's why. Here, cedar, go for that guy. Also going to need seeds. We're going to need He's still not there yet with this guy. Hello, Phantom. Yes, it is. It really is. Alright, so let's go here. Let's grab... Yeah, let's fill the cedar. Manually. go. Nope, that's not right. Oh god, this thing is heavy. Did I not attach the hoses? God, it's so heavy. Yeah, it's so heavy. Can I even disconnect it? Yeah. It's so heavy. This little tractor is just not doing it. I forgot that this cedar is really heavy. I will get this. Button, attach it, put the hoses on. And fill this. We'll get the rest later. Okay, so close the cover. Oh, good. If I fold this. All right. It is weighted down enough so that it won't die. So now, can I send you home? I can. You went a little bit too far. Let's do this way. Alright. Minor crisis averted. Let's bring you. Alright, here. Let's open the cover, switch over to the harvester, turn on the engine. Alright. And yeah. And put you back to work. Let's go ahead and move ever so slightly out of the way. Jump out, attach that. Now, we should do this on a return path. Bye, I guess. Thanks for coming. Now, we should pass our other buddy here along the way. We'll see what they're up to. We're doing that. Let's look for water. I don't know if I have water out here or not. It doesn't appear so. So we're gonna have to figure out how to get some water over here. So I'm drawing a path so that the tractors can drive themselves. Once you draw the path once, you don't have to draw it again. So I drew a path out to the farm. Now I'm drawing a path back to the main road. On big maps like this, auto drive is a savior. We're about to pass our buddy. You'll see him over here on the left. We'll see if he's tipped himself over or if he's driving on his back wheels with how heavy the cedar was. Yeah, they will stop and they'll go face to face, just like Factorio trains, and you'll get a notification. So, there's our buddy. Hey, buddy. So, we guys gotta get from here to the junction, and that's where our road was, that we can connect to. He's gonna keep going the whole way back that way, head back to our home. We got more gear still to collect at the store. Gonna need to buy a truck. A little bit short on cash, though, to pull that off. The highway. Stop recording. Make our junctions. And then, I don't know, I never made a store. Oops. Unfortunately, the store drive isn't a long drive. Yeah, it depends on which map it is. There are a lot of roads that are built into some of the base maps. One of the maps that I was playing earlier had no maps. The question was, never realized there were real roads in this game, and there are. You missed it earlier, Phantom. If you rewind the stream a little bit or watch it later, I had a big traffic jam stacked up behind a tractor that was only going 10 miles an hour. Alright, so over here, we should be able to... Come on. Do that, and make this the... tractor store. And send this guy home. That other guy is going to cause a major traffic jam. I can just see how loaded he is. We're going to put the cedar right here for now. Fold, I think, first. Yeah, kind of lower it first. And then detach it. Move forward a little bit for maneuvering space. And that down and detach. Come on, detach. Good. Let's go check on our harvester. Actually, just leave you sit there for a second. Let's go grab you. Bonk. Oh boy. She's feeling it. This tractor is massively undersized for this, but hey, that's all right. Well, I thought it was going to be that undersized, but here we are. So you have to compare the horsepower of the truck or item that you want to carry to the horsepower of the tractor. And then that tends to match up, and you want to have a little bit of spare capacity. So this trailer is compounded by two things. Number one, we've got wide tires, which are better than standard tires and narrow tires for traction in a field, but they're not as good as double wides or crawlers. So we're not getting good traction here. The other thing is this weighs about... Here, I can tell you. 15.3 tons. And has a weight capacity of 8.7 tons. This tractor only has 185 horsepower. So it's not pulling very hard at all. Ideally for a trailer this size, I mean, the large tractor can get it to about 10 miles an hour, but you're looking at probably bringing in a 500 horsepower truck in order to get it up to speed. You can. You can destroy your own crops if you run through them. When you initially seed them, it's okay. But after they go through their first growth stage, as you can see, I'm destroying crops here. I destroyed that corner of wheat. But after they go through their first growth stage, you can destroy them if you don't have narrow tires on. And narrow tires are designed to not disturb crops. But ideally, after you do your planting, you're only doing two things. Herbicide, if you have weeds in your fields, and fertilizing, if you need fertilization. I think what's going to happen here is after we get this out to the harvester, we'll leave it here, and then when the large tractor makes it back, we'll come back and pick this up. And we'll send the Massey back to go grab probably the bale wagon. The bale picker-upper. As soon as I get under this, you should start piping into it. And while he's doing that, we'll go ahead and detach and get out of here. So, with that done, let's send you to the store. And while he's doing that, we can figure out what we want to do over here. So, we're looking at building... chickens. And cows. We don't want the robot. We'll make our own silage. So we'll go with the... Oh, I didn't realize cows were so expensive. Okay, new plan. We'll start with just chickens. And we're going for the big one. Chickens will produce enough to make back the cost. So we're going to put the chickens over here. Hello, Russian friend. So let's put the chickens there. Let's go ahead and buy some chickens. All right, so we want 20 roosters. I don't think roosters do anything. They're just kind of decorative. And then we want... We're not going to worry about transporting our own chickens right now. Okay, I guess I'm buying them a batches of 60. That should be enough to get started. And then we need food, which we've got. Oh. Oh, we are struggling here with this guy. I didn't realize he was that heavy. That's 14.5 tons. Yeah, okay. Well, just means we're gonna need some bigger tractors here eventually. Yeah, I thought he was going to be a little bit lighter. So this is what we have here, one of these guys. But we need, like, One of these guys. One of the deers, maybe. Yeah. Hello, Russian friend. Alright, well. That's... We'll deal with it. But... I think that is going to do it for this evening. We're looking good. There it is. There's the traffic jam. Sorry. Hey. Yeah, I hear ya. Sorry. Sorry. You look like a stalker. Sorry. Oh, sorry. Hey. Sorry. We'll see you next time.